Oh, welcome to the show, Dr. Jeff Myers. Dr.
Hey,
Myers.
Dave, great to be with you.
Hey, yeah, thanks for coming on. I was actually reading an article. You were interviewed last week and by the Western Journal, and I'm reading that you said you're a little upset with Christians out there who say, well, I prayed about it, I voted, and the president didn't win, so we'll move on and try again in 4 years. And you're saying, a good Christian would stand up and fight. I agree.
I think so. I think to say, well, I voted, God's in control, I can't do anything else, it's bad citizenship and it's bad theology. You know, the citizenship piece is really important. Your vote does not get you across the finish line in an election, as a citizen. It gets you to the starting line. So I think it's really important. You know, there are enough examples that we have been dealing with for decades about election abuse, and it is a justice issue, and I think it's worth fighting. Plus, Dan, think of this. 80% of Americans say they do not trust government. So when the government says you must submit, news media says stop questioning this, they forgot psychology 101. That's the one thing that's going to get people questioning even more. If we want people to ever have trust in their government again, I think Christians have to treat this as one of those justice issues and stand up for free and fair elections.
I think it is a just cause that we have to stand up and fight for. I like how you say that apathy is one of the greatest threats for the modern church today. And, you know, I feel that Christians are so afraid to speak up because of fear of being doxxed and then canceled. And we've explained to folks, if they're in maybe an older bracket of age that don't understand the doxing, maybe they do, this is what the left has done now, thanks to social media. And of course, the social media giants don't stop them from saying it, but they blast their name, their addresses sometimes, where their kids go to school, where they work, and they try to ruin their lives financially, emotionally, and sometimes physically. And so it's tough for Christians to go, I got to stand up and fight for my president and for this election because this is what the left will do to me.
Facebook might cancel a message that you have, but what you're describing is trying to cancel a person, to make them as if they don't exist, to shrivel up in fear and shame and feel like their lives aren't worthwhile. It's been a tactic of the left, and for a long time, it goes all the way back to Lenin, who crafted this ability to abuse people and call them names, and it became standard operating procedure for the left. Some conservatives are good at it. But listen, 75% of conservatives say they have opinions they are afraid to share because they might lose their livelihood.
Yeah. I was there. I freely admit it. That's why this show is called Get Real. I was there. And I thought, if I post on social media what I truly feel about my conservative values, I will never, ever get back on television again. And it lasted for a few years. And thank God for Herring Broadcasting and One America News Network. How do we fight back? What do we keep doing when that is a true, true fear? Because it's a reality for folks. It does happen daily to people. So how do we continue that fight? We just have to have faith, right? And keep moving forward, keep voicing it.
I work with 40,000 young people every year through Summit Ministries. You can find out more information at summit.org. In fact, you can get that book that you mentioned for free at just summit.org/cancelculture. Then there are 20 things in there that you can do to fight the cancel culture. So it's just summit.org/cancelculture. But here are three things real quickly. Number one, we have to stop. Conservatives are trying to respond to this leftist impulse to cancel everybody and everything by saying, well, you're going to cancel us, we're going to cancel you. Just stop it. It's immature. It is not the way to handle big issues. The second thing is to get offline. Stop having Facebook arguments, stop engaging in the Twitter battle, just get offline, pay people for a cup of coffee, and have a conversation. And then the third thing is we have to be able to see this truth. So back in the communist days, it wasn't so much people believed all of the lies of communism, it's just that they lived as if they were willing to accept. We can't accept it anymore. We have to be willing to speak the truth. And I have a quick example of that for you. It's kind of interesting. Our attorneys right now at Summit Ministries are telling us that our religious liberties are going under attack if there is Biden Harris administration. And in the process of that, we asked them, what should we do? They said, if you're court and if you're being accused of following your convictions, he said there needs to be plenty of evidence to Now is the time to speak up rather than to quiet.
Yeah, there is plenty of evidence out there. Dr. Jeff Myers from Summit Ministries, grab the book. Again, it's 20 things to say and do to fight the cancel culture. Amen. I am on board with that because let me tell you what, firm believer, freedom of speech, freedom of the press. You should be able to say whatever the heck you want in this country and not get canceled for it. I'm in full agreement with you. Dr. Myers, thank you for coming on Real America. We appreciate it.
Great, Dan. Great to see you.
Yep. Up next, get real. But before, as we head to break, we have to, of course, take a moment to pause and remember on this day, 1941 was the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States